Welcome to this video. This is part 2 of the barcode reading tutorial series. Today, we'll build a Hello World application with the C++ package of Dynamsoft Barcode Reader SDK. It is going to be a Linux application which also works on Mac and ARM devices. If you want to build a barcode reading application for Windows, please check the previous video in the series. If you're ready to dive in, let's first check the system requirements, and you can follow the step-by-step tutorial in our online documentation. Download the SDK from dynamsoft.com and unpack the package into the directory of your choice. I will unpack it to this path. Make sure you copy the path of your directory to the clipboard, it will come in handy later. Let's go to the samples folder and open it in the terminal. We will create a new source file named dbrcppsample.cpp. Open it and include the library. Add the headers of Dynamsoft Barcode Reader SDK in the file. And don't forget to replace all the installation folder path in the code snippet to your own file path. Remember, we asked you to save it to the clipboard earlier. Okay, now let's add some code to the main function. Dynamsoft Barcode Reader is a commercial SDK, so you need a license to use it. You can request a free trial license from the customer portal and replace the license number here. Let's create a Dynamsoft Barcode Reader instance. Next, we'll configure some scan settings to get ready for scanning. We'll use Get Runtime Settings API to get the current settings and save them into a public runtime settings struct. Here we set the barcode format IDs equal to all so that we can decode all barcode types. The parameters of the SDKs are flexible and customizable. You can add some parameters to customize your own application. Call Update Runtime Settings after completing the configuration. To decode a barcode from an image file, we need to call dbr.decode file interface. You can specify the image path here. For the error handling mechanism, the SDK returns an error code for each function, and you can call the getErrorString function to retrieve the error's description message. Check out the documentation for all the supported error codes. Now, we'll write some code to process each result in a loop to output all the results. The SDK returns multiple data points about the barcode, such as barcode count, barcode format, barcode text, the location of the barcode, and more. All we need to do is release the allocated memory for the barcode results. Before we build the program, let's check again that you've already replaced the default installation folder to your own local directory path. Finally, we're ready to build and run the project. Make sure you have already installed GCC in your system. That's what we will use to build the application. Open the terminal and change it to the target directory where dbrcppsample is located in. Build the sample with the following command. Finally, run the program and get the results. And here you go. You just built the Hello World barcode reading application using C and C++. This was the the simplest code sample that demonstrates reading barcodes from an image file and output barcode format in text. We also provide other complex C++ samples. For example, reading barcodes from video frames or modifying parameters that optimize for reading speed and minimal miss rates. Check our documentation to learn more about how to configure these settings that work best in your usage scenario. Dynamsoft Barcode Reader is a cross-platform barcode reading SDK. With our SDK, you can create reliable barcode scanner software with enterprise-grade performance to meet your business needs. Check out the next video in the series to learn how to build a barcode reading application in Java. Thank you for watching.